Hi and welcome, I'm your host PC Enthusiast, and today I will teach you how to build a great gaming PC for $500. The best part is that it includes only parts that will give you great performance but also have open upgrade path so you can upgrade your PC to your needs. Without further ado, let's get into the build. For a CPU, I picked i3-7100. Yes, it's a dual-core CPU, but Hyperthreading opts for two additional virtual cores and will give great performance. It's a great bang for our money as it ships for only $110, and at this price point, it has no real competition. You can try to squeeze i5 in this build, but I personally would not recommend it, as then you would need to cut on GPU, and for gaming rig, GPU is most important part of the build. For motherboard, I choose Gigabyte Micro ATX motherboard. This motherboard goes for around $70, and for that price, you can't expect world beater, but it is one decent board. It has 4 DDR4 slots with total speed of 2100 or 2400 MHz for a maximum of 64GB of memory. It has no crossfire and no SLI support, but as this is a $500 PC, we're not looking for dual GPU configuration anyway. It has 6 SATA, 6GB and onboard USB 3 headers. The real deal is that this motherboard will allow you to upgrade your CPU down the road to an i5 or i7. But remember, this motherboard can't overclock, so don't go for unlocked CPU. For RAM, Team Elite Plus 8GB DDR4 2400MHz memory will do fine for gaming rig. I know some games start to recommend 16GB of RAM, but I still have not come across game that did not run fine on 8GB of RAM. If it happens that you need more RAM in the future, you can simply add more RAM. For storage, no SSD in this build, just a Seagate Barracuda 1TB hard drive. Considering this is a gaming PC, you probably want a lot of storage, because you will be downloading a lot of games. Also, considering that game file sizes increase every year, I recommend not to pick 120GB SSD over hard drive. 1TB will be sufficient for your music, movies and pictures as well. Moving on to the power supply. For power supply, I picked Seasonic S12 520W ATX power supply. This power supply is awesome. It is from Seasonic S12 line and will allow you to use it for any future upgrades to your system as it is very power efficient even at very low loads. Extremely low ripple and noise for a mid-grade unit for those that like a silent PC. And it is a shallow unit for space challenging cases and it looks great. It goes for $47. But why did I pick a power supply that cost almost $50 in a $500 gaming PC? Well, glad you asked. If you are building a PC for $500, I presume you do not have a money for a new motherboard when a cheap unbranded power supply burn it. For graphic card, I pick Sapphire Radeon RX 570 4GB Pulse ITX video card. It is a great graphic card and will allow you to play almost any game maxed out at 1080p. Even games like Witcher 3 can be played at high to ultra settings with great frames. Its closest competitor is EVGA GTX 1060 superclocked, as the cards run frame to frame of each other in every game title, but I opt for RX 570 as it is newer and might have a better support in the future. For case, the Roosevelt SRM Micro ATX case might be the best case out there for the price, as it goes for only $20. It has two USB 2 and one USB 3 port and mic and headphone jack in the front for convenience. Inside, there are two fans pre-installed for optimal cooling. To round this up, this was a $500 PC build for 2017. Did you like the video? If yes, hit like. Don't forget to subscribe and see you next time. I don't know why chick mentioned my name, but the woman's gonna get attention again.